one of the things we've been doing on Other Voices over the years is to put together a special at the end of the series. And tonight we've got a 1 hour long programme devoted to Fergus O'Farrell and Interference. Now, Interference was the very first band booked in the first season of Other Voices, a series presented then by Glen Hansard. Whatever happened to him? Well, Glen will be joining the band later on tonight to sing a song from the Once soundtrack, which is doing so much business now all over the world. And I hope you enjoy this hour with Interference.
There was blood inside this fruit, and I could taste the body of her love. And the flesh was fabulous and really good to eat. All you boys and you girls, we only know one world. It's a fabulous world to know. We only know. It's a fabulous world we know. If I wrote my love a two-step, don't you know she'd dance a waltz? But we'd be tripping to a music box, and I could hold the body of her love, and the touch would be fabulous and sweeter than the air.
Fergus, as I'm sure you know, people are never quite clear as to what Interference actually is. Is it you? Is it a band? Is it a co-op? Is it an organisation?
It's a good question, and maybe you could help me answer it. I don't it's something that involves Fergus O'Farrell that has many different shapes. But there's definitely a core of people. Like, I've played with Paul Tiernan for years. I formed a band with James O'Leary, who played Ebo tonight. And I've got various heads that kind of, you know, dipped in and out and whatever. So, if that answers your question.
Well, the other question that people always ask in order to establish what pigeonhole to
put you in, is what kind of bands you were listening to at the time and who were
influencing
easy. You?
That's well, for me, I suppose, it's a fairly easy question. If the earliest influences of me would have been classical music, Elvis Presley, then onto the Beatles, Neil Young, Bob Dylan, Leonard Cohen would be massive. Leonard Cohen would be a massive influence. I've gotten these weird pair of ears that I mean, everything to me sounds like music, you know, the wind blowing. Or so even though I don't really listen to CDs, I don't go out and research CDs or buy CDs, you know, but I mean, if you sit in cars or, you know, in airports, you're hearing music all the time, you know what I mean?
The slimy grey wet back platform takes the side, another train. One man alone at the station, one man standing in the rain. The doorstep of drizzle stops the tread of his life. He raises a bloody pan to the wind. Bloody pan clasps the head of a child. The double glazed mind's silent now. Only one man knows the rattle of the tap in the room and the musty cupboard smell. The warm range below Redstone, her body and her breath. Skies which shower over the first line, ease and memory. Lastly appeals over a sunbroken plain where a smile shines down on the world. Down. Only one man knows the rattle of the tap in the room and the musty cupboard smell. The warm range below Redstone, her body and her bread. The only woman knows the rattle of the tap in the room and the musty cupboard smell. The warm range below Redstone, her body and her I'll be your father, your knight of love divine. I'll be your punishment and I will strip you in the cold moonshine. I'll be your memory and quietly slip away. I'll present you with all religion and give you a ring every day. Cause I am your man. Nothing but a promise for eternity and a vow to grant me a body and a charge to rule your destiny.
All of those things you've mentioned so far, but the nature of the band, kind of music you're listening to and your approach to music suggests there wasn't a hope in hell of you ever having a hit record.
No. And I don't think there ever is either.
You must have known that at the time, though. You were heading into territory that was not necessarily productive in that sense.
I wasn't sure. I figured that I might do the Pink Floyd trick where you'd basically have one song that would, you know, keep people happy and then you could, you know, go up your own arse, so to speak, you know.
You think you did that?
I think I did it melodically and song structure wise. I think lyrically I was probably a little bit heavy handed. Although the older the songs get, the more I appreciate them and the better I think they are. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Well, you know, you had every reason to get dark and heavy and introspective and reflective and all of those things because of your illness or however you would put it.
Condition.
Condition. Your condition. Checked in to see what condition your condition is in. You know, because of that, and it's not that you ought to be forgiven for that, but it's very understandable that you would get very reflective.
I think it is, yeah.
And did that immediately affect the work?
it's did it immediately affect the work? I guess it did, but I wouldn't have been aware of it at the time, you know. I mean, like, for instance, Gold, everybody goes on about Gold, you know. I wrote Gold, a Dagdad tuning, I think it's called. I didn't know what tuning it is, I didn't even know chords. I could only play first position chords. The only reason I wrote Gold was that I'd written every form of, you know, the first position chords that I could do. I couldn't play bar chords because the hands were already too weak by the time I even started playing guitar to do bar chords. So I could only ever do these simple first position chords. And I just got bored of it, so I just detuned the guitar so that I could, you know, without moving my hands that much, find a different way of playing chords. So if I hadn't been disabled, I'd have had a greater range of chords. I might never have written Gold.
If the door be closed, then a row of homestyle buildings, and tear your curtains down for some. If your skin was soiled, how long do you think before they'd start again? And if your life was gold, how long do you think you'd stay
feeding the peasants. Chat for candy comes down like the rain. Ava's not able to eat from the table, as the throat got cut when Kane was using the razor. Gaynor's now barber him into fashion, and the Neolithic style is red all the rage. Chop for the barber, cried the man inside the tower. His mind was choked when the devil swung the rope. Why can't you see? It's not what I ever wanted. Just you and me. And what we believe. Was only faster when the flies took a trip on a ship to Mallorca. By the time they came back, the politician had the answer. Problem solved, some later disaster. But I blame someone sick, we were responsible. I couldn't take it, said I broke the handle. I came down really fast and said, hey, it's all over. I was only joking and the handle's still broken. Why can't you see? It's not what I ever wanted. Just you and me, and what we believe, and what we believe. Feeding the peasants and shot for candy comes down at the rain. Ava's not able to eat from the table, but the throat got cut when Kane was using the razor. Gaynor's now barber, heavy into fashion, and the Neolithic style is really all the rage. Shot for the barber, cried the man inside the tower. His mind was choked when the devil's on the road.
People like myself and a lot of the people working on this program who don't have a whole lot to contend with in life really can bang on forever about how wonderful music is and how it changes the world and it heals you and it helps you and so on. But you know, you do have something to contend with. What are your views then on the power of music?
I don't know what I'd be doing if I wasn't doing music. But if it's the power of music is extraordinary. I met my wife through music essentially. She really liked the music and that helped me convince her to come over to Ireland and eventually marry me or whatever. It's a language, isn't it? And it, you know, if you can get the language or if you're willing to immerse yourself in it, it's amazing what you can get out of it. Otherwise, you don't get a lot out of it.
But in terms of music, you know, getting you out of your depression, making you feel better about the world and life and seeing things differently. Again, it's one of those things, it's easy for me to say, but do you feel like that?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the best things I've written, one of the songs I'm the happiest with writing at the moment is this new one, one of the new ones, Titi. And I wrote that because I was brutally depressed one afternoon, having had one of these absolutely nonsensical screaming rows with my wife, whereby she'd been like insulting my family and I'd been insulting her family and stuff that had nothing to do with the what actually had been the problem. Even if there had been a problem, maybe it was just somebody got out of the wrong side of the bed. And I got up to the studio and I was going like, why? Like, Jesus Christ, and this is why human condition is in such a terrible state. Because, you know, if myself and Lee can do this to each other and we love each other, well then of course, what are people of different religions and different countries and whatever. So no wonder the world isn't crap like. And I just started playing the chord on the piano and it was just three notes and it was the right chord and then I once got that first chord, I swear to God, and I played the first chord for an hour. It just did something to my brain. Boom, doom, 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 doom is the bass. Boom, doom, doom, and just whatever the chord was, it was sucking the depression out of me. And then I just within an hour, the whole chord progression done.
So she's ready to fly through the ether of the night. Looking on through a storm,
whichever way the wind blows, she's gonna climb the long way home. And if you see me looking sideways through the white of my eye, you see I'm cold and lonely as a stone. We'd found the golden doorway, but we done lost the key. We can look for it together before we sleep. Baby, please sing it. My sweet love. No mediocrity. Time and our velocity.
Whichever way the wind blows,
whichever way the wind blows,
What do you do when you can't understand the language? What do you do when you're tired of the music? What do you do when you can't seem to dance? It's a shame the way you choose to go. Like a genuine hero who joined a traveling show. A broken Indian in Wild Bill's circus scene. Alone at night in your bed with the wind. Do you think of what was or what might have been? Won't you take me to dance in the streets of my last chance? It was in July when you closed the door. A decision you took on the killing floor. And now your head is swelling with more and more things that make the truth seem obscure. But that was all so very long ago. The seasons turned those green fields to gold. Just like the money that buys your peace, with jewels on your fingers and snakes at your feet. And the price of the door, men were all your prophets. We so won't you take me to die? In this dream. Today.
I interviewed Robert Wyatt a couple of weeks ago, actually, as it happens, and like yourself, he's in a wheelchair.
Oh, yeah.
There was a famous incident with him when he was to go on Top of the Pops, and there were people at the BBC who thought this shouldn't happen because, and I quote, Top of the Pops was family viewing, and he was in a chair, you know? It must be always an issue for you in terms of what you're doing is very public when you sing, when you perform. And either, I'd imagine on the one side people being all over you to be overly kind, and on the other side people not being able to hack it at all.
It must be hard to perform. I've been brutally tough, probably more on band members in the past than myself, because I never wanted this response from going, oh, you know, like they're looking to hear a song, it's going, oh, that's grand. And they look and they hear the same song, and it's the lovely boy in the wheelchair, looking, he's singing very well. Like, oh, isn't that lovely? You know, it couldn't happen. I want it to be so good that there'd be just no debate between, you know, one and the other.
I mean, lyrically, obviously, you know, have any kind of condition might preoccupy your mind.
Although, having said that, a lot of the lyrics were written with, like, Matt McClancy, who I went to school with, and we would have been very, like, anti the system, and, you know, the world is screwed up by our parents and we've got to make it right, you know, we can change the world, you know, like, so we didn't change the world, and I'm occasionally writing slightly lighter lyrics now. Written first kind of a song called Sail On, which I'm going to sing tonight, which so far has been impressing people a lot, but it's like a Nat King Cole number or something, you know. I couldn't have written that when I was in my early 20s. I wouldn't have allowed myself to write it, and now I think some of the best things I've ever written.
So, what would have stopped you in your early 20s?
Because there was so many fucking love. There was so many love songs. It was just like, you know, the world doesn't need any more love songs. It doesn't need any more hairdressers. What it needs is, you know, motivators and people who are actually going to, you know, do things, you know, important things, you know. But then you just cop on, don't you? Or, I don't know.
The moon is a ship at night, and it sails over a starry sea, and it sails a sea God loves to hear things they say into each other. Well, if life was a fairy tale, every word would come true. And as you lie here by my side, I'd whisper, when I see a shining flame falling through the burning night, I'll always think of you, wishing everything is so alright, alright. Say
sail on moon.
Do you believe at all, and again, it's one of these things that for someone who's not in a wheelchair, it's very easy to say, that out of adversity comes great work, comes great art?
Definitely. There's no doubt about it. No doubt about it. Work too. I mean, obviously, you got to put in the work. Like, but certainly, you know, if everything was rosy, posy, happy, you know, would Beethoven have written the stuff? I don't know. I think you've got to be hungry to enjoy your cheese sandwich, and that out of pain, you know, you want to be in pain, so you move to a place of comfort. And if whatever vehicle you're using is music or whatever art or whatever, making better houses or designing better toilets or whatever, you know, that's just the way for humans to go in general, certainly in art. Right?
Through the glass I can see the stars. Yeah, I was born with a wishing heart. No matter what life brings, I won't let it rattle me. When I'm up against the turning tide and everything starts to twist inside, won't go down on my knees, gonna let it ride over me. There's nowhere to go. I'm gonna float like a butterfly and sing like a bee. When I'm tangled in the mess of things and all the bullshit that living brings, won't go down on my knees and let it ride over me. Let it ride.